Welcome everyone on this Spring Boot and React tutorial. So today we'll build a school management application. So the goals of this tutorial is to create a school management dashboard with React.js, Spring Boot and MongoDB. In this dashboard, we'll be able to create and delete students and list all students. So please subscribe to the channel Java Growth to watch more video about Spring Boot and React.js and also Kafka and other events technology. So the final results of the application will look like this. So here we'll have our dashboard. Here we can manage different students. Here we are listing different students. So we can edit or delete some students or add create new student just here by putting the information about the new student. And after creating the new student, we'll see it just here. So in this tutorial, we'll need some tools. For the backend tools, we'll need EastJS, MongoDB, Postman, and Robot3T. So for the frontend tool, we'll need Visual Studio Code and Node.js. In this first part, we'll focus on the backend development. So to download those different tools, you can go on the different website. For example, for Spring Tools, you can go here and download your Spring Tools. For Robot3T, you can go here on this website and download it. And to start MongoDB on localhost, you can watch my old video about starting MongoDB on localhost. So the duration is about 2 minutes, so you can do it very quickly. So in the first part, we'll focus on the backend development with Spring Boot and MongoDB, and we'll test our different REST API with Postman. And in the second part, we'll do the front-end development with React.js, TypeScript, Bootstrap, and all the team. So let's begin by the backend. So let's create a new project. Let's share. So Spring Starter Project, School Management App, Application, or Project. Next. So we'll need Spring Boot DevTools, Spring Web, Spring Data MongoDB, and that's all. So now I am waiting for my project to be created just here. So I think my project is created. So I want to run my project on different port than the default port. So it will be 7070, for example. And for MongoDB, I will use StudentDB database. So I can open Robot3T to see my new database this year. So refresh. So I have my database just here, StudentDB. So in my application, I will use my MongoDB on localhost with this database just here. So I will refresh. And I don't need more configuration. I need one last configuration to be able to create collection on the MongoDB startup. So first I will create a model. So the model will be a student here. So here it will be a MongoDB document. So collection equal student or students. So I have to do some import. So we'll import document. So first I will need to get an ID, an auto-generated ID. I will need to get to write this annotation just here. Then I will need four field. So the age of the student here, the name of the teacher here, so last name of the student, first name, and now we are good. So we'll generate some getter and setter. I will go to source, generate getter and setter, and I have to I have to select all the field, then I will generate my getter and setter, and that's all. And to get the project cleaner, I will put my model in other package model just here. So I will also need a student repository to be able to get to do stuff on MongoDB. So it will be an interface. So here it's a repository. I will need to import. I will delete all this. So my interface have to extend from Mongo repository. So the object will be student, and here I will put string for my ID. Just here, the ID is a string, so I will put a string just here. So I have to import my Mongo repository, and now I am good. I will just put my repository in another package repository. So I am good for my repository. I have to import student, and now we are good. So the last thing is my to create a controller. So to create the student controller, just here. So my I will change the package, move, okay. Then it's a REST controller. I have to do some import. So in my controller I will use my student repository. So here student, the same. And my field have to be auto-wired. I have to do some import just here. And now I will create different methods to be able to create, delete, and list different students. So the first will be method is to create student. And the second one is for delete student, and the last one is for list student. So here, delete student. And so for list student, I will use my student repository, and I will use find all. So I will return this, and I will return a list of student. So I have to import list, then to import student. Now I am okay to list all the student, list students, just here. And here it will be a get mapping method. And for the URI, it will be list. So here it will be a post mapping, and here a post mapping. So post mapping, here we create, here post mapping, import. So here to delete student, I have to give an ID. So I will put it as a path variable. So here my path variable. String ID, I have to import path variable, and here I am using my student repository to be able to delete student by ID. I will put this ID just here, and the last one is to create new student. So I have to put some request body just here, request body. The request body will be for student object, and here student. So I have to import. And here I am using my student repository to create new student, and we are done. So I have to use insert method to be able to create new student, and now we are done. That was the last thing, and that's all for our backend development. So now we'll test our application by using Postman. So in Postman, we'll create a new collection, for example, school management app. So here I will have three requests. The first one is create. So here the second one will be delete, and the last one will be list. So for the creation, it's a post. Deletion, it's a post too. For the creation, it will be localhost here 7070, and here create. So for the deletion, it will be delete with some ID. And for the list, we don't have any parameter. We only have list, and now we are done. So to create a new student, I have to give some request body just here in JSON. So here I will have first name, last name, age, teacher. So the age will be 25, age. So I can retrieve my field just here. So first name, last name, the ID is auto-generated, and the name of teacher. So the teacher will be Maria Teresa, for example. The first name will be Mark. And the last name will be Owen. And that's all. So if I go in the RoboTreaty application, so let's begin by starting our application just here. So school management project, start. Let's do a first test of our application. So there is no error. Our application just here, but we are not able to read the database. So we'll check if the database is launched in localhost. So I think it's the case, but I will launch my database. And I will restart my application. Currently, I don't have any error about Mongo database. I have another error. I will check different properties. So I think this database is missing. So we try to check that. So here in my terminal, I have my Mongo database launched in localhost. Then I will open my RoboTreaty. And I will check what's going on. So it's loading. So RoboTreaty is not in very good shape today. I think it's about the new release available. The last there is some bugs in this release, I think. So let's go. What's going on? So it started to load. So I have my databases here. So we'll create a database. The database will be StudentDB. Okay. Then I will restart my application. Restart. So now there is no error in my application. So the first test, I will try to create this new student. So send. What's going on? I will go to my collection student, and here I have my first student. So that's a good news. So the creation endpoint is working well. So we create a second student. The second student will be a girl. So Marta Ona. The teacher will be Mr. Proper. And the age will be 20. So send. So here I have my second student just here. So now the first test is good about the creation. So I will create a last student. So Brian Murphy, the age 28, and the professor will be Dana White. Why not? So send, and here I have my third student. So I have created three students. So now I will test to list different students just here. So list, send, and I have all my different students just here. My three students just here. And to test the deletion, I will try to delete, for example, Mark Owen. So I will get this ID just here. So for the deletion, I will put the ID as a path variable. So send, and now normally I will have two students, so that's good. So our three endpoints are ready now for the backend part. We can create student, delete student, and list different students. So in the second part, will work on the React.js and TypeScript application. So we can list, use this method to list different students just here. And we can use this method delete student to be able to delete student just here. And we'll use create student to be able to create new student by using this model just here. So see you in the second part of this tutorial, and thank you for watching.